Welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. Every year there's an annual run of Hooligan, that's a fish, small fish here in Alaska. Well, Connie and I, we're going to take off on a trip and see if we can get the timing right so that we hit the run and try to get us some. Come along with us. For being on the river and other types of trips we do, we needed a lightweight shelter that's heated. So we purchased this Seek Outside 8-man Tipi. It's sil nylon. The teepee weighs 8 pounds something. It weighs less than 9 pounds. And the stove and stove pipe, it weighs less than 4 pounds. So the total package is less than 13 pounds. Let me take you around inside, show you how we've got the camp set up. Okay. Because of the sloping walls, we don't want to use our large cots. So right now we're sleeping on the ground until we can come up with some short height cots. Okay, in the back there is another door. Straight across from this door we just walked in. And here, let me back out here, give you a better perspective. Here is how we've got the rest of the area set up. Okay, we're back out again. That stove is all titanium breakdown stove. We purchased that with the tent as a package. So far, we're quite pleased with it, with the whole package.
Yeah. Whoa!
You got one. Okay, bounce it on the bottom.
I think the net's not inflated. Oh! My boots are stuck in mud. Just a minute. I gotta eat my other boot out. Okay.
Now let me explain this net to you. This is a homemade net that I made. The frame is a salmon net. I bought it at a thrift store for $5. It had a holy salmon net on it that was I could mend it, so I kept it, but what I bought it for was this. Okay, what I did, you can see here, down this side, I just sewed a seam over. Okay, I had a full sheet of this. I folded it over in half. I sewed down this seam, and I sewed across the bottom. Let me hold out this bottom so hopefully it makes more sense. Okay, then I took the top of it, folded it over, and sewed a seam all the way around. Now right at the joint, I left it open for a ways down, okay? And I took these screws off so that the net frame would come off, and I slid this on all the way around, and now I've got my net. And it works great. The only complaint I have with it after trying it out is I would not make a square bottom. And in fact, I might change this. I would make a pointed bottom, a conical bottom. That way, see, when I go to dump out the hooligan that I catch, I just flip this into that and turn the net wrong side out. But invariably, the hooligan get caught in the corner, and they don't want to come out until I pull the other corner and lift it up, then they fall out. If it had a conical bottom, that would be just a simple one-step process. Now, the long handle here, this is a handle off of my salmon dip net that I use for dip netting salmon. It's a huge net. It wouldn't have been practical or needed a net that large for the hooligan. So I took this little metal thing off of the salmon net, and I popped it into this, and this slips inside of the salmon dip net extension handle and holds it in place, and it all works really good. Direct from the river, to the frying pan. I wish you could smell these. They smell wonderful. All right, from the pan to the plate. This will be my first try of hooligan. Let's see how they taste. They're not the best fish I've had, but they're pretty good. They're different. These are called candle fish, another name for them. They're very high in oil. So when you cook them, you want to coat them in a... Well, what Connie did was use a flour, mixture of flour, salt, and cornstarch? Corn flour. She's nodding at me behind the camera. And fry them till they're crisp. All right, when you eat these, you just eat them bones and all. The bones, they're very soft. You don't even notice them. Now, texture, they're very soft, very not much texture to them, no firmness, but the flavor is good. It's a fish type flavor. If you enjoy fish, you would probably enjoy Hooligan.
Bending the net.
Well, thanks for coming along on this trip with Connie and I. We sure enjoyed having you with us. You folks take care, and we'll see you on the next video. Have a good one. If you enjoyed this video, be sure and give it a thumbs up and to share it, as well as subscribe so you don't miss any more. And check out these suggested videos here. Thank you.